Hey, what's up, guys? I'm back bringing you guys one of my first of hopefully many of mine in Crew Psycho's Black Ops 2 SND tips. And basically, this is a really, really simple one, but it's just planting the bomb. It's simply, as you guys can hear, the bomb is loud as hell when you don't spin. Now, when you spin, you can only hear him open it up.
Can you hear it?
No, Psycho, you cannot hear them planting the bomb, except for opening up the bomb. So basically, a very, very simple, yet pretty not very well-known tip is just spinning while you plant the bomb. It's back from Black Ops. It works to silently plant and defuse the bomb both ways, and actually have some insane pre-fires for you today as well. So when you're playing on hijack, people are pretty much bound to be running down this A hallway on the right side. And as you guys can see, you can simply pick them off by not shooting right where the metal beam is, but actually going slightly over to the right of the metal beam and looking straight over. There should be no water there and should be pretty much lined up between the two. And you can shoot through that thing and actually kill people on a pre-fire. If you put FMJ on, I'm pretty sure it'll kill really, really quickly. And in hardcore mode, it'll probably be a one or two shot kill, so a very, very useful pre-fire. Now we're going to look at the next pre-fire, which is actually really, really similar. It's just on the other side of defense or offense, because both these pre-fires go either way. And it is looking down the little, kind of it's like a building area, and you just got to line your sight up with the little beam, and once you line it up with the beam, you can easily pre-fire through it and get some pretty easy quick kills. Now finally, we're actually going to be showing you guys as well how to dodge a bouncing Betty, because why not?
Here, that one's good too, because you can just line it up without that.
So now on to dodging bouncing Bettys. If you guys remember Modern Warfare 3, when a bouncing Betty was laid, you could easily just run through it and dive to the ground. And you can do that too in Black Ops 2, as you guys see right here, but the detonation time is a lot faster. So essentially, right when you hear it go off, you're going to have to hit the floor. And you guys can see that pretty well right here in the kill cam. Basically, I run right through the bouncing Betty, and almost the second I get within range, I have to duck down or else it's going to blow me up. And easy kill. Now, however, if you're not interested in dropping to the ground right away, you can easily use another perk in this game that is actually going to help you and prevent you from dying from bouncing Bettys, and that is flak jackets. As you guys can see right here, I put on flak jacket, run through the bouncing Betty, and actually don't die. It pretty much does injure me. It severely injures me, but I don't die, and that's what really counts when it comes to playing Search and Destroy. You don't want to die from stupid things like bouncing Bettys. So that's our video, guys. I hope you guys really enjoy the tips and tricks. Me and Psycho, like I said, plan on doing a ton of these. We're going to have even more pre-fires on this map in the future, and on really any other map, get some SND across the map, Tomahawk areas, and just any other tips that we can find while thinking of or doing anything. As always, we will be coming at you with traditional commentary, zombies, and even our team dodges and crew sniping episodes. We're getting our clips together, and we're about to get really, really, really big as far as clips go. So anyways, I'm ThreeHoundDawg. I'm signing out. Shout out to Crew Psycho. Thanks for the help on the video, bro. And we'll be doing a lot more of these. So anyways, I'm ThreeHoundDawg. I'm signing out, and I'll catch you guys later.